It is in fact an honor to be here today speaking to you on behalf of the U.S. Embassy in New Delhi. Let me begin by thanking very much the Gandhavini Education Society and our host at T.P. Bhatia College of Science for so warmly staging this event and welcoming us all. Let's have a round of applause for them, please. Now, when I give opening remarks for conferences like this, somehow it invariably happens that I follow Amy. And as Amy was saying that she was echoing Rama, I'm going to be echoing Rama and Amy. So we're in an echo chamber here this morning. I'm really sorry for that. I must apologize. But unfortunately, this is the way it always happens. And it also, as Amy was speaking, it struck me that invariably, I sound as though I'm a competing car salesman coming up, saying, yes, the British Council is offering you this, but we are offering you that. But I don't want you to think that, in fact. I want you to see us as basically collaborators, allies, if you will, with you. So I think if Amy will allow me to speak for the British Council in the UK, the government of the UK, and we are, as she said, we are in this together, focusing on the improvement of educational outcomes for the people, the students, the youth of India. I found it especially heartening that we got time from an MP. That is actually quite significant. And thankfully, Rama made the most of that time, because we need to take those moments we get with the decision makers, with the policy makers, and we need to use them to our utmost advantage as educators, because their time is quite limited and their attention, unfortunately, is quite divided by all the many things that they have to address in the course of the day. But significantly, Rama pointed out the challenges faced by our colleagues who are working in government school contexts. Obviously, teaching English is challenging regardless of where you are, but I think we can agree that some of our colleagues working in government school settings, especially in more distant rural settings, face extreme challenges. That might be very large classroom settings, very limited classroom materials, any number of challenges, problems, as the MP said, that they have to address. So if we can focus his attention or our parliamentarian's attention on these areas of need, and also show that we are willing partners to help address those challenges, that's, I think, a major success. So good on you, Rama, for that. For a moment, I'll take a moment to note how the U.S. Embassy is doing its part to support the endeavors of English language educators in India. So obviously, we too are supporting this conference. And today we have with us, or in the next 2 days, we have with us 18 different U.S. English language fellows who will be presenting workshops. These fellows are all, as I said, U.S. citizens who are teaching in India, but also Nepal, Sri Lanka, and the Central Asian republics of Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan, Turkmenistan, and Uzbekistan. So we're coming from all over Central and South Asia to support the INDET conference. We also have, like the British Council, a number of online initiatives for English language teachers to avail. So if you, in your conference bags, you should have hopefully all received a copy of English Teaching Forum magazine, a hard copy of English Teaching Forum magazine. And inside that magazine, you will find reference to our website, which is americanenglish.state.gov. Through that website, you can find MOOCs and other online resources that are freely available as open including materials that you can use, for example, games that you can use with your students. Now, talking about how we assist government teachers, government school teachers, I'll give an example of one project that we are currently doing with the government of Delhi. This is in conjunction with TESOL International and the SCERT in Delhi. We have collaborated and combined forces to offer what is called the TESOL Core Certificate Program. It's basically a six-month blended training course, which we are offering to mentor teachers working with the government of Delhi's schools. Now, many of you are familiar with the work that the council does with state governments. And what I would do to just talk about the small difference between the way we operate and the way the council operates is that we operate through what we call educational exchange programs. The way our English language efforts, the US government's English language efforts work, is basically rooted in what is the preamble to the law that created our part of the State Department, the US Department of State, which is the Bureau of Educational and Cultural Affairs. And that preamble cites that our mission, if you will, is to promote the mutual understanding between the peoples of the United States and the peoples of other countries. So everything that we do in the area of English language teaching, but also in other educational areas, has to focus on promoting mutual understanding. Now, part of that, obviously, central to understanding, is language. And English obviously plays a key role in international dialogue. Now, the MP, sir, mentioned the importance of Indian languages, and we recognize that too. And in fact, we have other exchange programs through which US citizens come to India to learn South Asian languages. So right now, we have students in India through US Department of State exchanges learning Hindi, Bengali, and Urdu. In past, we've had a program with Marathi, and hopefully we'll be able to do it again. But the recognition, again, is that it's mutual. It's two-way. It's not just us coming here